The political consultant who wrote that illegal robocall in the 2010 election is on his way to jail. Julius Henson was sentenced after being convicted on just one count in the case, but it's his comments that may have cost him. iTeam lead investigative reporter Jane Miller broke the story originally. She joins us live from Mitchell Courthouse with the latest on the sentencing. Jane.
Sarah, many defendants in court on day of sentencing apologized for their crimes, not this one. Julius Henson railed on the prosecution of this case, calling it patently unfair and a witch hunt from the start. He was responding in part to what state prosecutors said, who wanted Henson treated more harshly than his co-defendant Paul Shurick, Bob Ehrlich's campaign manager in the 2010 election, even though Shurick was convicted on more serious charges. Prosecutors say Henson is a danger to the integrity of the political process. Henson's lawyer wanted probation before judgment, calling this a very minor crime, but the judge saying that Henson seemingly did not get the magnitude of the crime against him and of his conviction, sentenced him to 1 year in jail, suspended all but 60 days. That means Julius Henson is headed for jail at this hour. He was handcuffed in the courtroom. Prosecutors say they wanted to send a message in this case. They certainly got that. We spoke to State Prosecutor Emmett Davitt just a few minutes ago.
It's not just the actual charge itself, but a court certainly can and should consider the circumstances under which. This is not a situation where somebody just didn't want to pay for something and something went out without an authority line. The court can consider the circumstances under which it occurred.
And just to recall, this was the robocall that was sent to more than 100,000 Democratic voters in Baltimore City and Prince George's County in the 2010 election, November 2010 election, suggesting that the gubernatorial race between Martin O'Malley, the Democrat, and Bob Ehrlich, the Republican, suggesting that the election was over before the polls had actually closed. What Henson was convicted of was a conspiracy count for failing to include on the robocall, which he wrote, for failing to include an authority line. So again, to recap, his lawyer wanted probation before judgment. He got 60 days in jail, handcuffed in the courtroom, and is on his way to central booking at this hour. Reporting live today from the Mitchell Courthouse, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.